today. I'm Cheryl Carson. I'm a ruling elder here at Rockledge Presbyterian Church. I will be totally leading worship today with this lovely co-leadership group. And we're grateful that you are here. Pastor Sandy and her husband Tony are taking a well-deserved rest today, and they will be back with us next week. I wanted to let you know, for those of you who are joining via our live stream, you need to go get your communion elements now if you have not already brought them in with you. We're welcoming those who are with us in person today, and those of you who are joining us via Facebook and YouTube. We are the Welcome Church on the River, and we're glad that you are here with us today. For prayer requests and important announcements, please refer to the bulletin. If you're not currently receiving the bulletin, let the church office know. And for those of you worshiping with us this morning, we ask that you keep your mask on even while humming or lightly singing. I have several announcements for you. First of all, just a reminder that the Tuesday evening prayer service is continuing. It's at 6:30 on Zoom, and if you would like the Zoom link, you can either email me or contact the church office. The small group Wednesday evening lectionary study is continuing, and that's on Wednesday. It doesn't have a time. As I recall, it's 6 o'clock. Am I right, Brad? 6:30. And that, also get the link for that. And we are returning to the study of Fearless, Imagine Your Life Without Fear by Max Lucado on Sunday mornings. We just completed our Advent and Christmas study, and you're welcome to join us for that. It's also being done on Zoom. It's an exciting time. The men's group is going to restart on Saturday, January 16th. At 9 o'clock a.m. in Calvin Hall. You can refer to your bulletin for all the details, but you need to let Alan Foster know by text or email or by calling if you're planning to be there so they can buy a round out. And the Mission Committee focus for January is the Church World Service Blanket Funds Collection, and you are asked to January Rock article on page 6. The session has called the annual congregational meeting to present our 2020 report and the revoking of officer nominees, so please see page 1 and 2 of the January Rock newsletter for the nominating committee slate for January, Sunday, January 17th at 2 o'clock p.m., and that will be on Zoom also. Your Zoom invitation will be sent closer to the date. If some of you have been missing the opportunity to have manna bags to distribute to our friends who may be homeless or hungry that are on the streets, they have been prepared and are ready to take that into the community. We thank especially Ann Foster and Lynn Britton for coordinating that, and you can keep the donations coming to the manna box in the narthex or in the church office, or you can contact Dean if you have something that you need to deliver. It should be in the narthex afterwards. Is that the hand signal?
You can pick them up. You've got them a
lot. Okay, sorry about that. I misread that hand signal. They are here, and if you are present with us, they pick them up in the just for then remembering some of the folks who continue to need our prayers, we ask that you pray for Phil, continue prayers for Donna and Rick and Nancy and Jeffrey, and also Tom and Casey and Kelsey and Jesse. There are lots of anniversaries and birthdays, but especially lift up Don and Lorette. Anniversary is tomorrow, and Ed and Jean, whose anniversary.
Good morning.
Good morning.
But a community that connects in Christ, God, one another, and the world, let us call ourselves to worship. Promise us you are able, and let us do our call to worship responsibly. Light of God, illumine the path that leads us to healing, hope, and salvation.
Glory to God. Fill this
for these boys, Harrison said, I'm trying to give them permission to be whoever they want to be and giving them a voice that they wouldn't normally get in cinema. He was even nominated for a Rising Star Award from the British Academy of Film and Television Arts. Now that's a rising star in all aspects of life, be it entertainment, science, technology, whatever. We insights, but here are a few things that strike me. First, the Magi are actively looking for the coming of the Messiah, and they aren't even Jewish. As the Isaiah passage tells us in verse 4, lift up your eyes and look all around. If the wise men had not been looking skyward, they would never have seen the sign displayed by the rising star. I'm not saying that we have to constantly look to the stars. What I hear in this is a challenge to us to be aware, watch for the Spirit's movement in our lives. Here's another thing that I discovered for myself in this gospel passage. The Magi respond to the discovery of the sign. They don't just sit in Persia and say, well, gee, that's a really neat star. It portends the birth of the Messiah. Maybe somebody should go and take a look at that. No, they know. They follow the stirring of the Spirit, and they set out on a journey. They don't even have a gifts to serve the Lord and cultivate new ways of giving you might not even know that you possess. Go and follow the risen star.
Let us confess the faith of our baptism. Please pray.
we adore